What's up, everybody? This MTB Minister T Breeze here on Band Conversation. I'm glad y'all checking in with me. I'ma tune y'all in to some new guests, give you some of my latest guests coming up and his new projects.
What is going on in here?
Hold.
Why is you got these lights?
Hold up, Ms. Those, we recording right now. I can't talk right now. We record right now.
I don't care about no recording. I just want to know what you're doing. Why is all these lights in my face? Oh my god.
See, there's a camera right there.
Is the police?
I'm trying to talk.
Is the police?
Is the camera right there? No, ain't police. We know you got one, Ms. Those. Look, we just trying to record the show. Is the
police? Surprise! How you doing? How you doing?
You gonna sit down and interview
with me? Yeah. I didn't work all night long. I've been cleaning up buildings.
This podcast, this band conversation. So what we do is we tell the people about what's going on, and I got a guest coming in. We gonna interview him for the show.
The band gonna play on the conversation?
No, not the band. It's just called band conversation.
Right. I got two boys down the street. Quincy, Jane, Cornelius. Ron J. In the band.
Band conversation. It's pretty much saying we talk about stuff that don't nobody talk about. That's what we try to say.
Oh,
I know you were saying with them boys back in the day. We ain't not that kind of band.
Oh, you're my little secret, like Bandit.
All right.
Band
conversation.
All right.
Look, we gonna talk this over for a minute, but then I'm coming back and we gonna talk to our real guests after this.
All right.
If it's over,
right.
We gonna clean or do something.
All right. All right. Watch out.
Remember, iHeartRadio every fourth Sunday, 9 p.m. I'm your host, MTB. And I got the man here with me, playwriter, songwriter, actor. I ain't got enough fingers to tell you what all the man do, but we got Pierre McElhaney in the building. Y'all see him right here live and in person. Evermore, y'all just seen him, so y'all already know what I'm talking about, who we talking about. We gonna interview him right here on Band Conversation. So welcome to the show, brother. We appreciate you being here with us, gracing us with your wonderful presence here on Band Conversation.
Well, I don't even know what to say after that great introduction, man. I'm just really, really blessed and honored to be here, man, with my brother.
Right. Real. And so just say, I don't know, we are shooting in Gastonia, North Carolina. Gastonia's on in the building, so I know y'all be seeing him in Atlanta, ATL down there my way, all the people. But he's from Gastonia, though. Born and raised right here in Gastonia. So I'm going to let him do his own resume because I don't want to mess it up. So I want you to tell the people where you come from, how you come, how we got from there to him. I'm gonna let you get your own resume.
Gotcha. Again, man, I appreciate you, Pastor T, Minister T Breeze. I appreciate you, iHeart Radio. I'm Pierre McElhaney from the beautiful city of Gastonia, North Carolina. Doesn't get any better than that. I reside now in the Metro Atlanta area. I am a husband, I'm a father, I'm a son, I'm a brother, I'm an uncle. The most important thing to me is I'm a grandfather. So I love that I have four beautiful, wonderful grandkids. So it started years and years and years ago, right here, right down the street, New Hope Road at Center Baptist Church, and just started acting in some church plays. And a lady named Ms. Brenda Boyce, I always shout her out because she allowed me to do my thing, and it sparked something in me, which took me from there to becoming the most talented male at Ashbrook High School to be the best one in the world. But I know Minister T. Breed got one down there in Georgia. You know, that's
Crown High School. Yeah,
boom. We got those. We right there, one and two somewhere in there. So I after that kind of went on to college to major in travel and tourism. Ended up leaving early because I went to audition for one of the management teams that used to manage Joe. Mm-hmm. And so went up to Jersey, did that. When I came back, Miss Janice Feaster, who was my godmom, who wrote the great, great play, Get Your House in Order, that later became A Fool for Love, that went on tour with Marvin Webster and Marvelous Entertainment. So from there, she got me an audition with the great Adrian Williamson, started an audition for My Grandmother Prayed for Me, and we went out 94, Norfolk, Virginia, a couple of spot dates. 95, I'm in school, I get a phone call and say, we need you in Mobile, Alabama tonight. Either take it or leave it. And if I didn't get to properly withdraw from college, it was just like,
I ain't gonna be here tomorrow.
I hollered. I said, Mama, can y'all get my stuff together? I'm gone. I told my roommate, Jimmy, I'm out. Holler at you, God bless, and rest his soul. And left, man, and the rest is history. From 95 to where we at now, My Grandmother Prayed for Me, opened the door, and I didn't even know how to do half this acting stuff. Mm-hmm. But man, they worked with me. Went to Albemarle this last Saturday, but all that started on Albemarle World where we rehearsed that. So this is where we at now, man. So
now you got the name drop now. I need your name because I done seen your wall. So you got to tell them about some of these people that have been in these plays that you done, that you've been hand in hand working, man, side by side with.
Man, I've been blessed, man, to work with the great Donald Gray, who's a director, who's been on BET multiple times with his shows. The great Donald Gray, Terrence Cotton, Walter Johnson. I have to now throw in who's nominated year in and year out, who's won multiple awards. So when you're award winning, you have to throw that name in too. So TJ Austin, it goes in as well. It has to go. It is what it is. I said Walter Johnson, Zach McElhaney has to go into that. My own child, but he has to go in there now. Cuba Gooding Jr., Cuba Gooding Sr. from the group Main Ingredient. Everybody Plays a Fool. Had a chance to work with him. Johnny Gill, who of course, my New Edition, you know, LSG, you know, we can go on and on and on. I know the church folk don't know anything about LSG or who are they? So he was on the show with us. Dottie Peoples was on the show with us. And that's just to name a few. I mean, we've been blessed to work with a great, great plethora of folk, like Seven Lee, who's major. Elaine O'Neill Mooney, major. JJ Mooney, major. All done major work, even some work with Tyler and some other things. So this names, I mean, with people we've met, people we've done work with, but those are some of the great people I've been blessed to work with thus far.
Right. So then you went from acting to writing your own productions with S, production. Yes. So tell us about some of your production, the stuff you had a hand, you wrote it, then you typed it, and then you threw it to us and like, hey, read this.
Well, I like that. Well, but man, what he started back in school with poetry, and that's what I'm really trying to get into, maybe doing a poetry book. You maybe can help me, you and Red, your wonderful wife who do it, so maybe I can get into that one day. But it started with poetry. I went from poetry to writing songs, so I wrote a few songs. We did some stuff, and now, as you said, the name drop, let me go backwards real quick. So with the writing, it started from there. Then we opened up for Wu-Tang.
Mm-hmm.
Opened up for Wu-Tang. Also opened up for Immature, which then became IMX.
Right.
So we opened up for them. So I had a little run with touring, and I used to choreograph dances and had four people with me. Shout out to Darren Glenn, a.k.a. Hollywood. So that's a name drop. Hollywood was one of my backup dancers. And he was, that's what got him.
That's why he take his shirt off all the time. That's what that is right
now. MTB, you don't realize. It was him and his cousin, Jeremy Leach. Brian, who used to be at the scene with us, his brother, Darren, goes to Atlanta. He shows out. Jeremy goes to Philly, he shows out. But because Darren went to Atlanta, he said, I'm going to just try something. We ain't practicing none. He knew all the moves.
Right.
End of the show, he takes his shirt off and the girls go crazy. Damn. So Darren Glenn, damn, shout out to Hollywood. I was writing, doing some stuff, choreographing. So we had four adult dancers, then we had 12 kids. So we had like 20 people on stage at one time, and I choreographed all that. So it went from there to doing the shows, and then somebody asked me, you think you can direct? I directed a show, had a chance to work with the great Pastor Billy Howes, and sorry, I love to talk with my hands, the great Billy Howes and Kenya Howes and the writer Tammy Bean, they gave me an opportunity. Mm-hmm. Cynthia Stitt, who is an amazing writer from this area.
Gastonia,
North Carolina. I feel like two of the best writers I've ever been around is Cynthia Stitt and Wanda Mooney. Bad. Marcus Mooney's mom. Mm-hmm. Bad writers, I mean, they can go with the best of them. You can give them an idea, right, and in a week they got a whole script.
Child, Cynthia Stitt, I was in her play. Ms. Mooney, hit me up.
It's
Christmas time. I know you got a Christmas production.
Ms. Mooney, hit him up. Y'all already know how we do it. So I got a chance to work with them by directing their pieces. And after I directed their pieces, I started thinking, getting a little itch. Like, I could do it. I was like, nah, I wrote plays. I could do it. It was until I met Otisha Johnson, mm-hmm, who said, you need to stop playing around with it and go in and go for it.
Yeah, that's just how she talks.
Like,
look, I don't know why you meant, why you playing with money. That's how she talked to us.
Exactly.
Y'all don't know Otisha, that's how she talked to us.
Otisha Johnson, I'm telling you.
We really scared her a little bit.
In real life, this much, really. But she'll push you into a place. That's why I was saying just recently, don't be worried about saying, don't push me because I'm close to that. No, if you're really in my corner, we're really covenant. Push me to that place. And she did. She pushed me. I wrote it in a matter. I wrote Mama Back in 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. I wrote it in 3 weeks and then gave it to you guys.
Right.
And once I got that itch, then came with it. Mama Back came in 2013. Mm-hmm. Then With This Ring came in like 2015. And then Back to the Riches, I think, came in 2019. And now I'm working on a new piece. And so it's just like now. And now I'm doing, me and Zach are doing some small YouTube stuff, getting ready for some web series. Mm-hmm. So the writing has become a lot easier. I get scared of block. I get real scared of writer's block, but I'm just, man, blessed to have great people like yourself, y'all, man, because I'm only as great as those I work with and I serve. So I've been blessed, man, by these people who give me opportunity. So, yeah.
All right, so listen, we're going to give y'all a little bit more. We're going to take a quick pause. We're going to drop some music, maybe show you some clips from some of the plays that, you know, we can't give you everything because you got to buy your tickets. But then we're going to come back and we're going to get more with Pierre McElhaney right here on Band Conversation. I'm your host, MTB, Mr. T Breeze. Make sure you tune in every fourth Sunday, 9 p.m. iHeartRadio. Make sure you go to the YouTube channel and subscribe so you can see all these wonderful interviews and videos and independent artists that we're dropping. I'm still here with the great Pierre McElhaney, Gastonia's own. Y'all might know him as Otis. You know him as all the other characters that he do, but guarantee you, you need to know who we talking to right now, straight out of Gastonia, North Carolina. We're recording in Gastonia, North Carolina. So I'm going to let him take the floor one more time. I want you to tell the people what you got going on right now,
okay,
some of the stuff that you've written, some of the things you got coming up. Give them names, dates, time,
okay,
places. How much the tickets is, they need to know so they can get their money right. It's Black Friday, hear where we at now.
Right.
Get your money right.
Right. I love it. So coming up, we just came out of Albemarle, North Carolina. Shout out to the great, awesome Dwayne Streeter for promoting and investing in the show Only One Mama. We just did that this past Saturday. And it was amazing. Greats like this man was in the show that took the stage and just really, really showed out. Coming up on December the 5th, we're doing a show called Christmas with the Callaways at the Cobb Galleria. He can tell you more about this because he knows all these places. Ain't nowhere in an Atlanta area I can't name.
Right.
He'll know exactly where
it is.
Cobb Galleria in the Atlanta area, and Christmas with the Callaways. It's going to be like a nice intimate setting, 3 p.m. It's going to be like a reception, a little luncheon type thing, real smooth. And at 5 o'clock, we kick the show off. It's gonna be awesome. My birthday is that Tuesday, December 7th.
Right.
So, you know,
y'all know.
We be popping it in and getting it right on back out of there. So that's on December 5th. So then we're gonna jump to February. We're gonna skip January, as my grandmother used to call it. So we'll skip January, we'll go to February 5th. The great Kalisha Headwalker from Chicago, Illinois, by way of Stockbridge and Jonesboro, Georgia, who is gonna do her awesome show called Hosea. Amazing show that's going to be in Newton, North Carolina, literally a few minutes from where we were. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be an awesome piece. I'll be able to put more out there. Minister T Breeze, aka Pastor T, will be able to give you more information as well. But that's going to be this coming February 5th in Newton, North Carolina. February 12th, we are dropping chocolate covered strawberries. God gave it to me in 2014. I didn't finish the project. We are at a good place, and I can already tell you one of the great cast members is going to be a part of that is Gigi De Niro of 94.5, excuse me, down there with Young Jock. Shorty, what my name is. Yeah. That station is on fire. She went from intern to now like one of the main faces. So she's already signed on board, man. It's about to be amazing. Chocolate covered strawberry dropping February 12th. You need to get your boo ready and come on out and see it. That's gonna be amazing. I'll drop a location soon, but we're gonna be in between North Cackalack and GA. Right. So it's gonna be one of the two. We'll know more this coming.
It's gonna be close by.
Yeah. So be ready. So that's that. March 22, Tamika Chambliss wrote an amazing short film called Ruined Twice Blind. We just filmed that in Memphis, Tennessee a few months back. And man, post-production has been crazy. I got a chance to be a part of my first post-production on a short film. And it looks like they're going to do a full feature film with this. But Tamika Chambliss just won probably 25 awards for her show Timothy in the past couple of months. And they continue to call with winning. So that in March 2022, dropping Ruined Twice Blind. But that's going to be amazing. Film from Memphis, Tennessee. April, we kick off the documentary from a place that I was born and raised, down there where the Outreach Center is, called Brevard Heights. Name of the documentary is Ain't Nothing Like BHP. That's April 2022. That's what we got going on so far, and I'm just excited about what's to come.
So that's up to April. Now, after April, you might not be able to get in touch with him because you ain't going to be catching up from all the stuff that he already said. So, like I say, the phone going to be ringing, and you ain't going to be able to get in touch with him. So that's why you got to catch him now. Because after April, ain't no telling. We ain't going to be able to get in touch with him. So I'm getting my interview now. Y'all got to get y'all's because after April, it's going to be over. It's going to be done.
Right.
But then you mentioned this, so I want to throw this out there. Okay. You say you're doing a documentary, but we also, in your stage play, there's some film production as well.
Yes, sir.
In
yes, sir.
Your opinion, you prefer the stage or you prefer film?
You know what? I was asked and approached several times. Hey, what do you think? What's going on? How do you feel? It's so crazy because what I didn't mention is one of the guys came to the show Saturday. They're in a conversation with some stuff with Lifetime. Mm-hmm. And then a book came that one of the guys is doing, and they presented the book to me and said, hey, I heard about you. Let you write a piece. Mm-hmm. So to hear that and just to know that there's an opportunity, I like to be very straightforward. Hey, I'm not already there. I'm not signed with Lifetime. That's the truth. But to know that there's an opportunity for me to write and be a part of that world, I feel like I'm leaning more towards the short film to see what it feels like,
right,
than to maybe go full feature. But I do feel that I will have at least a short film by the end of 2022.
Yes,
definitely.
Now, I think, my personal opinion, I think the stage is definitely your area. I know you mastered the stage. But what I always tell people, because, you know, sometimes we have two shows. Sometimes we have, you know, the matinee, and you have the evening show.
That's right.
You got to get tickets for both of them.
That's right. That's
people
right.
Like, well, you know, which one is going to be better?
That's right.
You got to get both of them. Whatever we do in the morning is probably not going to go that way in the evening.
Exactly.
And it's going to be the same storyline, but you're going to miss some.
That's right.
And you're going to be mad at yourself because everybody's going to be talking about the morning show. You wait until the evening.
Exactly.
Or vice versa. So
yes.
You got to catch both.
Yes.
So that's why I always tell people, when we got more than one show, just be it all up.
Right,
because you never know.
Right.
And they were like, they didn't do that last time.
Right.
The show didn't.
Right.
But you didn't know that. But you know, everybody else, we knew.
That. And that's the advantage of live theater. Mm-hmm. You talk to people like this in TV and film. A lot of them will tell us that we have an advantage and stuff like that. And there's people like crossing over now from TV film going to do Broadway. You'll see a lot of them go do Broadway. Even regular plays. It was such chitlin' circuit deals back in the day. Now folks just want to work.
Right.
But we don't have that camera to say cut.
Mm-hmm.
Take one, take 20, cut, come back, hey, wipe the makeup, do this, change it. It's live, it's on the fly. That's why people love live entertainment, because it's just boom, boom, boom. A track is good, but live entertainment, you can't duplicate it. So, I mean, it's a great thing. And that's the beautiful thing about live. If you have a matinee and an evening show, you will get that same base, but you're liable to get anything from the opening to the end.
Ain't no telling what's going to happen.
No telling.
So that's something I had to learn. Because I remember we was doing shows, and you'd be like, hey, T, go out there and say, I'm like, that ain't my script. I don't know. He's like, but so-and-so mic ain't working. Jump out there real quick and do this. Or we be out there and the lights supposed to go down, they don't go down.
Right.
The curtain supposed to play, they don't come. So we just keep going.
That's right.
And that's just something you're not gonna get. You know, even though you know it might be funny, it might be a little serious, whatever the case may be, you can't beat what's happening right at that moment.
Yep, exactly right.
All
right,
so this, we want y'all to make sure you get in touch with the great Pierre McElhaney. So give him all your social handles.
Let me make sure I got it right, please.
Yeah, right,
let me get it right. So
they be calling. They be like, hey,
cool.
It didn't come up when I put it in. So,
I'm learning all this good stuff myself. So I'm sure he can kind of make sure I got it all down below. Well, up top, one of the ways. This man knows how to work it.
If he say something different than what's on the screen, go with the screen.
right. So my email, you can get in contact with me. Email Nizo Entertainment. That is for Nevez Zoe. That is my son, my 14-year-old, my first grandbaby. So Nizo, N-E-Z-O, entertainment@yahoo.com. Nizo Entertainment, that is my email. My Facebook is Pierre L. McElhaney. That's Facebook. And Instagram, so I just said I had to learn how to get this. It's backwards, McElhaney Pierre. McElhaney Pierre on Instagram. So the rest of them, my kids still clowning me on. I have a Twitter. I don't even know how to get to it. I'm learning the rest of it. Y'all pray for me.
On one of them, you're going to get him. So whatever one he responds to, then you know you got it right. That's what we're going with.
Yes. All
right, so we got the great Pierre McElhaney in the building. We're going to take another quick break, drop some music, maybe an independent artist or something like that, and then we'll be back right here on Band Conversation. Remember, every fourth Sunday, 9 p.m., iHeartRadio. We'll be back. All right, y'all, that's it for us. Band Conversation. Remember, every fourth Sunday, 9 p.m., iHeartRadio, right here on Pillow Talks, Band Conversation. I'm your host, MTB. I got great Pierre McElhaney with me. He gonna give you some shout-outs before we get about here. Anybody you want to shout-out, say what's up to?
Man, I want to start off with giving God praise, and I want to say, hey, my wife, Shannon McElhaney, I love you.
That's it. Everybody else don't matter. We see y'all all the time. But, you know, we got y'all next time. All right, so we out of here. Band Conversation. Till next time, y'all be blessed. We are gone.
I just pray through it. Fall on my face and I might make